Ever since the dawn of humankind, the moon has been a captivating presence. We've marveled at it, suspended in our sky, wondering what its purpose is, and wondered how it came to be. In this, our space age of discovery, however, we've gotten to know the moon better than ever before, thanks to modern science and technology. But still, the apparent split between the near side we continually see and the far or dark side of the moon is something that has kept us guessing. So, this is Unveiled, and today we're exploring the extraordinary story of how an ancient asteroid split the moon in two. Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. We know full well how integral asteroid impacts have been in shaping the history of Earth, with the last major asteroid collision famously signaling the end of the dinosaurs and the rise of the mammals. But actually, in comparison to our own world, the moon has withstood a far greater barrage of space rock. It's why the lunar surface is so pockmarked with craters scattered like deep scars to show the cosmic turmoil that the moon has experienced. But still, whenever we look at the moon, we're only ever seeing one side of the story. Because the moon is tidally locked to Earth, we always see the same face of it, which means that there's always another face looking away from us into the rest of space. It's commonly known as the dark side of the moon, although scientists prefer the term far side, because really, it's not especially dark at all. And contrary to popular belief, the far side is no longer completely hidden to us, either thanks to various space missions fronted by America, Russia, and China especially, that have sent probes over to the other side to beam back images and data. One thing we know for sure about the far side, then, is that for all the impact craters there seems to be on the near side of the moon as we look at it, there are many, many more across the part we cannot see. The impact craters aren't fairly spread across the moon, with the far side hosting hundreds more of them than the near side does. And for decades, this has puzzled scientists and astronomers. Why should that be? Why would what's essentially a spherical object be more prone to asteroid collisions in certain areas, but not others? If the findings of a new paper ring true, however, then that puzzle may have finally been solved. Details of a multi-authored study led by members of Brown University and with contributions by NASA were published in the journal Science Advances in April 2022. The study focuses on what it calls a South Pole-Aitken impact origin of the lunar compositional asymmetry. In other words, the lunar compositional asymmetry is a reference to the moon's uneven crater distribution between the near and far sides, while the South Pole-Aitken impact origin is what researchers think is to blame for that. The South Pole-Aitken basin is one of the largest known craters not just on the moon, but in the entire solar system. It's some 1,600 miles across its widest point, and it was formed around 4.2 billion years ago, close to the beginning of the moon's life. While most of this colossal structure isn't visible to us on Earth, however, because it stretches onto the moon's far side, one edge of the basin skirts the lunar south pole, the moon's most southerly point. This means that a small portion of the South Pole-Aitken basin is just about visible for us, rising on the edge of the moon as we look at it, before dipping out of sight. But why is this region especially important for this particular video? Well, the April 2022 paper suggests that the impact that caused the South Pole-Aitken Basin may have had an even deeper impact and more fundamental effect on the moon beyond just the crater itself. Up until the impact, it's thought that the moon's mantle, just below the lunar surface, was reasonably evenly spread. Its geochemical makeup was balanced all over, and so the subsurface conditions within the mantle, anywhere on the moon, were fairly uniform. But after the impact event, that all changed. It's thought that the asteroid that caused the South Pole-Aitken Basin also triggered a disturbance or surge in the moon's mantle, which resulted in a massive rise in volcanism on the near side. This immense shift led to the creation of the Lunar Maria, which are the dark patches we can see splodged all across the moon all the time. In days gone by, astronomers believed the Maria to be literal seas, but now we know that they're essentially lava pools, long cooled off and darkened into the shadowy shapes we see today. But if we were to view the far side of the moon, we'd find many, many fewer examples of these lunar maria. There are more craters back there, but there are also fewer lava leftovers. And that's important, because it's the lava pools, the maria, that have essentially filled in the craters on the near side. And that's why there appears to be far fewer craters on one side of the moon compared to the other. So, to recap, the model put forward in the April 2022 study says that when a massive asteroid struck the moon some 4.2 billion years ago, creating the South Pole-Aitken Basin, it also triggered a surge in the moon's mantle, which led to more volcanism on the near side specifically. This volcanism then led to the formation of the Lunar Maria, which filled in many of the craters that had been on the near side. And that's why the near and far sides look so different nowadays. Geologically speaking, they host wholly different conditions as a result of intrinsically different histories, both of which were set in motion by something of a sliding doors movement in the solar system's early timeline. In a statement released by Brown University relating to the paper, study lead Matt Jones explains that he and his team ran a series of digital simulations to calculate all the ways the South Pole-Aitken impact could have unfolded. And in all of them, the same skewing of the lunar mantle toward the near side of the moon was found. What we show, said Jones, is that under any plausible conditions at the time that South Pole-Aitken formed, it ends up concentrating heat-producing elements on the near side. He goes on to explain his team's expectations that this contributed to the mantle melting that produced the lava flows we see on the surface. It might seem bizarre that one event literally billions of years ago could have such dramatic, long-term consequences. But really, this type of profound realization isn't unusual for astronomers. When we look into our planet, our moon, or the solar system, we're looking at a system that's never stood still. It's always been on the move, and it shows no sign of slowing down anytime soon. For billions of years of its life, there have been countless collisions, crashes, moments of creation, and moments of destruction that have specifically shaped the future from that point onwards. And the South Pole-Aitken impact event is one of the most significant formative moments for the moon in particular. Going forwards, though, it's not as though everything about this lunar region is now solved. In fact, the South Pole-Aitken Basin remains one of the most contested, controversial, and crucial areas of the moon in general. In mid-2019, news broke of the discovery of a large mystery mass lurking beneath the crater, said to be five times bigger than Hawaii's Big Island. At present, we're not exactly sure what it is, although most theories tend toward it being some kind of metallic leftover from the asteroid that started it all. Regardless, it's a sure bet that this part of the moon will be one of the most studied as we move into a new era of space travel and technology in which One day, it's hoped that we will return to the lunar surface ourselves. When that day comes, perhaps we'll be advanced enough to stick around this time, to set up moon bases, and stage missions that last for weeks or months, and not just a few days. The Apollo moon landings of the 1960s and 70s remain some of the most iconic moments in modern human history. But all signs are that we'll be adding to that history soon. And if we do ever set foot back there, then perhaps a journey to the far side will be at the top of the agenda. Because, at least now, when we get there, we'll have a better understanding of just why it looks so strange. And that's how an ancient asteroid split the moon in two. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.